Happy Valentine week, everybody. Here is your Valentine treat as promised. I felt like the world needed a little bit more love. So this treat is supposed to celebrate loving someone, loving yourself, being the king or queen of yourself until your magic person arrives. We got the cookie monster over here delivering cookies. We got the snowman down here who is... Yes, he is that song from the National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. And we have all kinds of special ornaments on here. We have Moosey. This is my old cat Moosey. We have his adoption day and also the day he got his angel wings. And then we have Pepe Le Pew with his love giving her a present. Yes! All right. Getting ready for our stretching video today. I just finished the other workout video that I made, and I like this song. It's called Heaven Is Where You Are, and some of these ornaments on this tree, and this one right here, this butterfly, symbolize people who are no longer with me, but they can still live on through me, right? All right, getting a little chilly in here, so we're going to put back on our shirt. So hope everybody is having a magical day. And let's give some love to ourselves by stretching out on our little ball. So, you know, I have three of these. That's why I love this cabinet. I can put all my little exercise toys in here. And so, you know, I got, again, these at the dollar store. And you can do the same thing with these. We're going to kind of play around with these this morning, just like we have been for our stretching video. But today we're going to do something just a little bit more interactive instead of breathing today. So still try to keep thinking about your breath, even though you know, I'm not kind of flowing along with the breath. This is more like exercise stretches to show you for your benefit that I usually do in the mornings. Okay, all right, so let's just start my warm up. I like sitting on the ball. All right, now this one is a little too high for me, so you know, I'll sit on one that might be a little bit lower. And sometimes you might do too much one day and you might be a little tight and like, I need to sit a little bit closer to the floor. So you might want to get just a smaller one to sit on. And you can even do the same thing with pillows that you have on your couch. It doesn't have to be the ball, okay? So we're going to take that foot and we're going to cross it over like this, just like we did the other week. Remember when we were talking about the lion and how the lion was sitting, okay? All right, so we want to sit kind of like the lion statue over there, right? With our hands like this, but we're sitting on that ball for me. All right, so making sure we're kind of comfortable. So I want us to kind of get into that movement as we're pushing. And as you do that, kind of push that hip down just a little bit. And then we're going to take it to the other side and push that hip down just a little bit. And then we're going to reach out. And if you have one of these balls and you want to put your hand on it to kind of elevate you, you can. Or get a pillow from the couch. And then we're going to rock over to one side for me. Now, as you do that, your elbow should be kind of on the ground. If not, just do the best you can. Okay. Now, our elbow is here on the ground. You can kind of feel that good stretch through your side. And bring those arms around. Again, inhale, exhale, and bring that elbow underneath your hip a little bit. Just try to stretch all through this area. You can kind of give yourself a back massage in this area if you feel like you need to kind of loosen up and stretch out through that tissue a little bit. Bring your hands out to the center for me. We're going to do the same thing again, but this time if this foot was on top, we're going to switch the feet, and then you're going to put the other one on top. So remember why I went over this, that this, yeah, this feels good, but sometimes, you know, for this type of stretch and practice, it may feel better to do that, and it also helps, I feel, keep your back in a better alignment to do some of these stretches, okay? All right, so we're going to bring that ball out and It doesn't matter which side you go to, just pick one. I'm going to this side because I went to the other side last time, so there's no wrong or right way to do this. And we're gonna pull that back, stretch. Plus this side feels like it might be a little tighter. Push that knee down for me. And reach out to the other side. Coming all around, bringing that elbow down. And you can even take that ball and put it underneath your elbow if that feels better to you. That actually feels better to me. And I don't feel like I'm having to reach so far to the floor. So you can do the same thing with some pillows from the couch. Massage that area for me. And bring that ball out to the center. And come up. So a lot of these stretches I do kind of in the morning just to wake myself up. I don't like the winter time and I move a little slower and it's dark and cold, and so like that's why I like working out in the yoga trapeze and try to stretch my body and move around besides just going and hitting start on the coffee pot or the tea, whatever I choose to drink that day. All right, so we're gonna bring that ball down for me to the foot and back up, reach up and bring that ball back to me. And bring that ball up. Now, if you want to, all right, you can do this while you are laying down. So reaching out, and I go all the way back, and I come all way up. Now, if you can keep that foot underneath you, good. I'm not one of those people, all right? I'm trying to kind of coming up like this, but some people are stronger than that, okay? So do what you can. Miss Smith is showing her kryptonite. And come around to the other side. Here we go, reaching out, warming up the back of those legs. Reach up and reach out and reach up. If you like any of these tracks, I will leave those in the description box below. And reach out and come up so I do not own the right. I got better on that side, look at me. Maybe I'm prepared. And whoa, and up. I think we did two on the other side. We're just going to do two on this one. All right, lay it on your stomach for me. Gonna take that ball and it's gonna start at your knee for me, and we're gonna roll up to our hip and come back. Hope everybody's doing well. There's a lot of people have suffering from congestion right now, so I'm just trying to keep myself as healthy as possible. It's almost like a sinus infection that never turned into a sinus infection. In fact, I don't get sinus infections anymore. I've really been trying to learn a lot about frequency technology and how it's helped me. And yeah, I don't suffer from a lot of the chronic conditions that I used to. And it's very freeing because, you know, nobody's got time to be sick. All right, so we're stopping at our hip for me, and I want you to raise up. My other leg is kind of like this on the outside, like in a figure four. And if you get a cramp, just put your leg back, all right? Just because that's how I have my leg doesn't mean that that's what you need to do. All right, taking it to the other side for me. All right, so we're reaching toward the knee and then coming back to the hip. Reach into the knee and coming back to the hip. Reach into the knee and coming back to the hip. And we're going to stay right there for me as we raise up. And again, this leg can be out to the side or you can put it back here. It's up to you. You decide what works best for you, folks. All right, let's do that again on the other side. So we're starting at our hip for me, and we're going all the way to our knee, and going all the way to our hip. And you can kind of go up even to where the rib cage is if you want to, if that feels better for you. And you can see my foot is kind of coming up as it hits the couch, so just be aware and come up. I could be going forward, but I like kind of pushing against that couch. And I can't do that if I'm facing you guys. All right, I'll push this up with my other foot. Good stretch. Okay, take it to the other side. Bring yourself on top of that ball. And, oops, coming forward for me to the knee. And going back up to the hip. Forward to the knee. right there and look up. All right, so let's put our hand over here on the couch. I'm gonna move this so you guys can see a little bit better. There we go. This is, you're probably wondering what this is. I found this rock when I was hiking one day at Pilot Mountain, and this is where it came from. If you guys can kind of see the message on the back, let me see. You can see the message. Let me read it to you because I can't read through that. It says, find me on Facebook at East Central Ohio Rocks. Post a pic of me and rehide me. Use my hashtag to follow me. And then it says, hashtag JEWETTUMK Rocks. Okay. Anyway, I got somebody that needs a little love. And so I have that there to inspire me. Like, please send that to them. They need a little bit of love. So I just happened to see that when I came over here. All right, folks. So take your ball. If you don't have the ball, don't worry about it. Just do the best you can. We're going to bring that forward and try to stretch out through our shoulder. And I kind of like using the ball, but if it feels a little bit unstable, just use the couch or the chair. All right, and you want to kind of go down through your back here. Now, if this hurts your knees, make sure that you put a pillow underneath your knee. You're going to bring your arm around to the side for me. Inhale, exhale, and every time you exhale, you feel that shoulder blade kind of open up. Keep your arm really tight. Keep your arm really straight. Relax through the joint as you turn, like a millisecond, okay? I want you to think about turning as slow as maybe you see a snail moving. That's how slow you need to be turning as your arm goes from 12 o'clock position over your head. Keeping that arm straight, open it up as your body is still leaning down and you're almost at the 2 o'clock position now. That's how slow that you're going. Opening up through that chest. You might feel some tingling sensation maybe going from your neck, from your shoulder to your wrist. Open it up through that chest. And as you get closer to the 3 o'clock position, go down a little bit more. All right, now we're going to go back up, going back over the area that we just went through. So now we're going back to the 2 o'clock position. Keep your arm completely straight, folks. Reach that arm out. Relax through the shoulder joint. Think about how you want that muscle to fire. Think about nice, long muscles, not those muscles that have been all tensed up and hunched over. Grabbing the pillow at night, grabbing our steering wheel, grabbing our phone, grabbing the computer, right? Oh, and we're almost at the 12 o'clock position. Allow all those little intrinsic muscle fibers to try to fire just a little bit differently as they get up closer to the 12 o'clock position. Oh, now that should feel like a little bit different in your arm, okay? Because we were actually moving it nice and slow and allowing your body to kind of relax through that stretch position before we just force it. All right, let's do the same thing on the other side. Let me go get a chair so I'm not showing you my good side. Woo-hoo! Let's see what that chair looks like in the video. You can see it. Sometimes if I turn the video around to where I can see what's going on, the film is not as good. So I'd rather have better quality video. All right, here we go. So we started at 12 o'clock position, yes? All right, so we're gonna do the same thing again on the other side, pushing our chair out, reaching down. So Miss Smith, I don't know if you guys have seen my kitchen in videos, but I've got 4 different chairs that look like this. We got a red chair, green, blue, and
yellow. Keep your arm up, guys. Keep that arm straight, not allowing the elbow to bend. So we're going from 12 o'clock, nice and slow. We're going to 11. We might feel that shoulder loosening up just a little bit. Nice, going through the shoulder blade. Imagine that you're just relaxing through that shoulder. You're not holding on to the chair. You just have your hand placed on the chair. And we're turning nice and slow all the way to 10 now. We turn our knees just a little bit. Remember to put that pillow underneath your knees if you're having a little bit of discomfort. Kind of move your head around if you need to. Keeping that nice arm nice and long. Try to imagine that your arm is just being pulled, okay? It's not being pushed, it's being pulled away from you as you are just rotating your body. So it's like you're pulling your arm out as you're relaxing and then stretching. So pull the joint away from the muscle. Now we're going to go back after we reached that other position, the 9 o'clock position. And we're going into the 10, nice and slow. If you feel something that kind of is hung up, just relax through a little bit. Reach on. Getting closer and closer to the 12 o'clock position. And you can even rotate your body, you know, if you get to that point. Oh, and that should feel real good to our arms. All right, so I want us to have a seat in the chair for me. All right, so we're going to roll those shoulders back for me. And we're going to bring, let's do the other arm that we started with. So bring your hand underneath the chair. You can do this also by sitting underneath your seat and sitting on the ball if you wanted to, if you don't have access to a chair. But if you do, this may feel a little bit different. All right, so roll the shoulder blades back. Bring your hand underneath. Keep your chest up. So we're going to bring both hands underneath. Inhale, exhale. And try to think about inhaling from here. Exhale. Now we're just going to drop one side for me and tilt our head over. I'm going to do the other side. Bring that hand underneath and tilt that head over. And back. Okay, so we're going to roll those shoulder blades back. This time I want us to bring your hand here. Okay, we're going to bring our hand up. Bring your hand underneath the chair, right? You can kind of lean back in the chair if that feels more comfortable to you. Bring your hand here as we stretch onto that neck. Now I want you to walk those hands around to the back of that neck for me. You might feel it pulling that neck just a little bit more. Walk your hands around to the back of that neck. Around a little bit more. Turn your chin into your chest. Walk your hands back a little bit more, stretching out. And you can even take your hand and kind of rub on the back of that neck. Roll those shoulders back. Let's do the same thing on the other side, my friends. All right, so we're going to bring that hand here. All right, I like to have my hand up like this. I feel like it's a little bit more relaxed. I'm not pulling on my neck. And then I'm going to roll my shoulders back. I'm going to grab underneath that chair. Let's stay here for a second while everybody gets together. Bring your hands on top of that ear. Good, good, good. And walk those hands around, chin to chest. And bring that hand back to the back of that skull. Walk that hand down. Good job. All right. Let's hold on to this chair one more time. I'm really into stretching out through the shoulders today. I think that it
definitely will help a lot of people. And then we're going to work on our legs after this. But many of us, you know, we only stretch out our lower body and we don't even think about our upper body. And, you know, that's half of our body weight that's sitting on those hips. Yes, if this is not stretched out properly, this is not going to feel good. But sometimes it could be compensatory. We might have some issues going on with our shoulder that could be related to our hip. But let's go ahead and stretch this out first. Okay, so this is just a little bit more than what we had before on the couch. So we're standing. Keep those knees slightly bent as you have the chair here. All right, so now what I want us to do, we're gonna take one hand down. All right, we're gonna have our knees slightly bent. I want you to reach this opposite hand towards your opposite foot. All right, now I want you to straighten out those legs as much as you can. Don't lock them out, just straighten them out. And bring this back up for me, please. And reach down again for me. Bring that hand down. Let it just kind of dangle for me. Make a circle if you need to. Reach toward that other foot. Keep those knees slightly bent. Arm is straight, arm is straight. Straighten out the legs as much as you can. Open up through the shoulders. Good job, good job. And coming back. All right, so now we're stretching at our chest again. Let's see if we can't go a little bit more, okay? So we have our hand in. All I'm doing is kind of bending my knees a little bit as I'm stretching out through my chest. So let's start at that 3 o'clock or 9 o'clock position, whichever way that you are looking at this. And we're going to nice, slow turn, relaxing. Try to think about your wrist being pulled away from you by the chair, top of the chair. And we're turning our body nice and slow, just like we did on the couch. But this is just a little bit higher. If you need to kind of drop a little bit more, you can. Keep your arm as straight as possible and really reach through those shoulder blades. You might feel like your arm is being pulled out of its socket as it is being stretched over maybe some of that scar tissue or knots that you have underneath your shoulder blade. All right, let's take it to the other side for me, please. Make sure everything is still in the line of the video. And there we go. These chairs used to look beautiful until my cat got a hold of them. All right, now, I've had these chairs. It was the first piece of furniture I ever bought back in 2000. Oh, we started here, didn't we? On this side. Back in 2004. So they are 20 years old. They look pretty good to be 20 years old and have gone through a couple of moves. More than a couple. And we're reaching out to the side. Nice and slow. Keep that arm stretched. Woo! Arm, reach out, reach out. Try to think about your arm being pulled away from your body as your wrist rests on top of the chair. The chair is your pulley system. We come back here. Good job, folks. All right, so let's bring that chair back around for me. All right, so with this one, I'm going to put my foot up this way. If you want to have a little bit more of a stretch, you might want to put your pillows up there to stretch it out a little bit more. All right, so I'm going to put a few more pillows up there. All right, bringing that foot up. Ugh. Everybody, this is why I like pillows. You can get high or low, right? And we're going to reach into that stretch. Keep that knee slightly bent that you're standing on. And come back. Bend that knee just a little bit and then straighten it back up. But I don't want you to lock out the leg. You keep it bent but not locked. And straight but not locked, if that makes sense. Try to straighten out that leg a little bit more, or you can jump back a little bit more as you stretch out through that outer leg. Kind of push a little bit on that outside knee if you need to. Walk that foot back a little bit more, again, slightly bending that knee. Now what I like to do here, you can keep here if you need to, if this feels safe for you. If you want to take it up a notch, I want you to try to straighten out your leg. Now my foot is not pointed away from me. My toes are pointed toward my shin, so make sure that that is a 90 degree angle and not straight, okay? That makes sense. So it almost, your toes look like a shark fin coming out of the water. That's dorsiflex. All right, and straighten out that leg. Good. Now, this might feel like some tingling going on in the back of that leg. If so, take one of those pillows out. All right. They're getting on my nerves. So slightly bend that knee. I'm going to reach over to the opposite part of my foot. All right, if you have your chair there to hold on to if you need it. I really like taking this and turning the chair around. That way my foot doesn't go away from the chair. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So if I have it this way, my toe won't turn over to the side and make the exercise easy because it's being stopped there, okay? So if I was here, okay, I'm pushing, 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 and my toe right would be right here against that chair and it can't go anywhere. So I'm feeling this stretch right here. So my toe is actually facing towards you. All right, but I can turn it up if I want to, but I feel a little bit more when I have it turned out. All right, taking it to the other side, let's do that again. All right, so I'm here stretching out through our outer hip. Again, you can see that's not doing a whole lot for me, so I need to make sure that I have these pillows up, and I can always move it down. All right, so sitting up nice and tall for me, stretching out through that hip. So we bend that knee, and then we straighten out the leg, but we don't lock it out, okay? So focus on getting the, squeezing the glutes and squeezing the quadriceps. Bend that knee, stretching out through that calf and the soleus. Keep that heel down, and then straighten out that leg again by squeezing your quadricep. Let's do that again. Bend that knee, and squeeze that quadricep. Close your eyes if you need to. All right, leaning down into that stretch. We're stretching those legs out nice and slow. Try to push that knee down if you need to. And if it's getting too difficult for you with all those pillows, take them down. All right, so stretching out, push that knee down if you need to. Remember, stay there if that feels comfortable. If you want to go with me, straighten out that leg just a little bit more. Turn in that toe. All right, remember, it's turning towards the chair. And on the other side, what I had done, I had taken this pillow out and I had moved, I kind of come like this and I straightened it out to where my toe is going towards the back of the chair. So I'm feeling the stretch to that IT band. Make sure that knee that you're standing on is bent and it's not locked out and that you're standing close enough to the chair. If you keep standing back further, you could hyperextend the knee and we don't want that. Reaching over towards the outside, stretching out through that IT band a little bit more. All right, now let's stretch out through the hips a little bit. We're gonna bring that foot up onto the chair. Again, if you need a little bit more elevation, that's what the pillows are for. All right, bring that foot up for me. All right, slightly bend that knee, reach forward, and you can kind of pull yourself with that chair and push back and reach forward. Stretching out through that hip for me. Reach those arms up if you feel balanced. If you don't, grab the chair, that's what it's there for, and come back. Let's do that again. Reach forward, stretching up through that hip. Reach up this time, so grabbing the chair if you need to. And I like doing this because I'm able to open up through my hip flexor more, and my arm and my hip, my foot are one unit, and I can see that when I do that, okay, that's hard for me to stand up vertically and do this, okay, because I'm all hunched over like this. And I know if I am, other people are as well. So whatever position that you, especially if you sit a lot, if you drive a lot or sit behind a computer a lot at work or for school, that really, you know, affects how your body kind of just comes down on itself, all right? Taking it to the other side. Reaching forward and come back. Reaching forward and come back. Good job. Stretching out right through here. And again, pull yourself to that chair if you need to. That's why it's there for balance. And I'd really like for you guys to reach up, try to dig your heel into the ground and try to open up through that rib cage. And if you need to, lean to the side a little bit more. Try to focus on keeping your elbow back, right, as we're stretching out
through your hip flexor and through your side body. Let's do that other side again. Did I just do that side? No, this is the side I just did not do. I think about it for a second. Again, reach your arms up, and I like to bring my hands down like this. So if my right leg is down, my right elbow is up in the air, so it's the same side, not the opposite. That doesn't feel the same, okay? Because we really want to stretch out through that side. All right, so we've got our hands here, and standing up nice and tall. And reach down a little bit more. Inhale up. And you can straighten out your arms if you need to. And let's take it to the other side for me. Because our hips are so tight, we don't even realize it. Reaching those arms up, reaching them to the side, bring that elbow back, try to stand on that foot. Elbow is up, straighten out your arms if you are able to. And good stretch right through here. All right, gonna move that chair. All right, so let's stretch out through our glutes just a little bit. All right, so we're gonna bring this to a pigeon pose. We're going to have our foot here, and our other leg is gonna come back behind us. So it's almost like being in that chair standing, okay? Except for our leg is relaxed. We're not having to stand up in a vertical position. All right, come up a little bit more onto that leg if you are able. If you are less flexible, your knee is here. If you are more flexible, your leg is here. Straighten out that back leg if you can. Imagine standing up, but you are horizontal. We want to push those toes down and stretch. If that's too much for you, keep your feet like that. You decide what works best for you today. All right, taking it around to the other side for me. And bringing that foot back. All right, straighten out those legs if you want to for the pigeon pose. And keep your toes down. Or you can bring your foot down, it's your choice. Let's see what time it is. Got a few more minutes. Now in the workout video that I did before, we were playing Darude, and I was telling them about this shirt that I had. So that was the music that I used for the last video, and this DJ had signed this shirt 4 different times, but I think I've seen him actually 5. Nonetheless, my husband went to go see him when I was married. Went to go see Darude, and he signed this shirt for the very first time. And I think the last time that I saw him, it said 6/8/19, and that was in Charlotte. And I remember him coming into the club and him seeing me on the left-hand side, and he saw me for the first. He saw me before I saw him. So anyway, good dude. He always has a lot of energy at his shows, so check him out. I know that you guys know who he is. Look up the song Sandstorm. I'm sure you'll know. All right, so reaching down, feet together, knees apart. And I was thinking about my husband. That was our last holiday that we got to celebrate back in 2005. And so it was a really cute experience. And it was our last holiday together, was Valentine's Day. Unfortunately, he's no longer with us. He passed away in April of 2012. Bring those fingertips in, open up those forearms. And so I started thinking about him recently, and I think, you know, my stepdad had passed away in February 2019, and we're getting close to the anniversary of his passing, and my mom's been kind of going through some emotions, and me as an empathetic person, empath, I think I've been picking up on some of those. And so, it was nice to remember him and look through pictures on Sunday and just remember where I was. And, you know, even though, you know, I'm looking at these pictures, and I think that what makes us kind of sad about anniversaries of someone passing is because we think about there's no more pictures, there's no more music, there's no more art.
And I'm like, well, that person can still live through us because we can celebrate them for the gifts that they shared while they were here, and celebrate them that way and do something that was their favorite. For example, if you're missing your grandmother on a certain day, if she was a good cook, maybe make your favorite dish that she used to make. That's a beautiful way to celebrate that person, besides being in a state of sadness. And I know that everybody processes grief differently and time heals. And so if you're going through something recently, right now, whether passing of a pet or a loved one, or maybe you've transformed yourself and the death of the person that you used to be. That's what my tree is all about. Right? Let's spread love and positivity, and you know, try to find something magical that happens every day for you and be thinking about that. That's why I like to do those weekly check-ins, because sometimes we can have a week of Mondays, right? Not every day can, or every week can be a week of Saturdays. Anyway, hope that this stretching video helped you out. If you got something out of it, please make sure that you put that in the comment. And if you have a loved one that you're celebrating or remembering right now, leave them a message in the chat and let me know how much that they mean to you and maybe a favorite memory that you have of that person. This is Nine Lives Energy. My name is Christy Smith, and together we energize your body from the inside out. Thank you.